Good evening. Welcome to Mattsquatch Presents. This is the special one-year anniversary video. This is going to be the 10 types of North American Sasquatch, the ultimate edition. One of my very early videos I did was about the 10 types of Bigfoot, and it was very popular. And I would still consider it about 70 or 80% correct. There's some updates to it, some things I moved around on the list, some things I've added to it, new information as I grow. So this is the quintessential video, the ultimate guide, especially for around the country. I'll kind of mention where these things are. Obviously, with 10 of them, I can't go into a lot of detail. But for most of these varieties, I've gone into detail in their own individual video. And if you look in the description, I've got a whole bunch of those videos linked there. And for me, this was really when I started to realize that, you know, there's two or three major types, and then there's a couple more rare ones, and then there's a lot more rare ones, and there's a lot of things that are associated with Sasquatch that I really wanted to talk about. So that was kind of the evolution of me eventually just coming up with a list, probably a couple years even before I started doing Mattsquatch Presents. I had on my phone in the notes sections where I just came, okay, this variety, okay, people are seeing this, and then putting little notes about it, and then I said eventually I wanted to make a video. So here's the 2018 Ultimate Edition. Maybe this is something I update every year. And hope you guys really enjoy it. Thank you very much. Let's jump into it. Okay, so we got a lot to cover here. The Type 1, or what I refer to as Type 1, real popular. Now, a lot of people put these in different orders. But the Type 1s and 2s seem to be pretty consistent. The Type 1s are your classic patty type. These ones get really huge. These get 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 feet tall, 4 feet wide at the shoulders. These are the really big guys. These are synonymous with the Pacific Northwest and your classic Sasquatch. They call it Patty because the Patterson-Gimlin film is a great representation of what this looks like. Very hair-covered, very large, omnivorous, tend to be a lot like a grizzly bear, although a lot more even-tempered. Out of all the Sasquatches, the Type 1 is probably the most gentle, most shy. They're seen primarily on the West Coast and then going all the way into, like, across the United States, these things are spotted. Now, a lot of these varieties do cross over, and you'll have different varieties occupying the same areas, although I don't think they interbreed. I think maybe they keep to themselves. But the Type 1 is your classic big patty type. So jumping into the Type 2, also known as a wood booger, if the Type 1, the patty types look very gorilla-like. These have a very chimpanzee-like. They don't have as much of a sagittal crest on their head. They tend to be a little smaller, being 7, 8, 9, 10 feet tall, built a little more slightly. I mean, we're still talking a huge animal. If the Type 1s are grizzly bears, these are the equivalent of black bears. They tend to be a lot more aggressive and a lot more excitable, kind of like how chimpanzees tend to be a lot more aggressive and a lot more excitable over like a mountain gorilla would be. So I think that's a pretty good analogy. These are all over the South, going down into the Southwest United States, into the Southeast, and all along those areas, kind of creeping up. I don't think these things go in super cold climates, being a little slightlier built. I think these are your classic wood boogers, your swamp apes, you know, the Falk monster, all that kind of stuff. The legend of Boggy Creek, wood booger type activity all going through. This is your classic type Bigfoot. Now, a lot more rare is a Gugwe, and these seem to be kind of along the Missouri River Basin and a lot of those areas going up into Canada. These are a lot like a Type 1, but really gnarly. They have a protruding snout. They're often talked about as being kind of a dogman derivative, and there's different variations of a snout, but I like to think of them more as a giant overgrown baboon, or like a mandrill type more than like a dog type face. But they're very nasty, purely carnivorous. Many people who have encountered these things, there's nothing good to say. There's lots of information on these guys. These things are pretty much like your worst nightmare with Bigfoot, along with the Wendigo that we'll talk about here in a little bit. But the Gugwe, as they're called, a lot of people see these things. Now, they have a man-like leg, not a dog-like leg like you would associate with a dog man. The Beast of Seven Shoots is a pretty good representation of one of these things. They're hunters. They're carnivorous. There's not a lot of reports of these things living in big family groups and packs. They're kind of big lone hunters. A Type 4 in my category of Type 4 is a Relic Hominid. Now, I will give a lot of credit. Some people don't include these because they think they're pretty much the same size as a patty type. they just don't have the facial hair. So some people think that the type 1 and the type 4 are the same. It's just the type 4s are just have less body hair and less facial hair. I break them down because their temperament seems to be a lot more aggressive than the type 1 patties. But at the same time, they have a lot more human-like face, almost like a Neanderthal. That's why they're like relic hominid. They look like a giant overgrown caveman as opposed to a giant overgrown ape. Now, like I said, a type 1 and a type 4 could be one and the same, just kind of different, you know, different variations of the same, kind of how black bears in the Sierras look different than black bears in the Rocky Mountains. So who knows, but this is another variety that people see primarily on the East Coast. In the Northeast areas, a lot of these are reported, and they tend to be a little bit more aggressive, like I said, than the type 1s, but still very large. Now, another variety that seems to be more of the alpine type is the fearsome Wendigo. These things are as big as a paddy type, getting 7, 8, 10, 9, 12, 13, 14 feet tall, but they have razor-sharp fangs and claws, tend to be white. They tend to like the snow in the colder regions. If a paddy type is a grizzly bear, this is more of a polar bear, where they're purely carnivorous. They're not really seen in packs, although I'm sure they have some kind of a family group. They might be related to the Gugwe that has the snout, but these definitely like colder climates. Seen in like northern Minnesota and in Canada and then going on up to different areas, though they tend to be kind of rare. Also on the East Coast, the legends of the Genosqua kind of tie into this. I made a whole video about this. For me, the Wendigo Bigfoot's absolutely fascinating. Like I said, just think of the polar bear of Bigfoots, because polar bears are purely carnivorous and will hunt down people and whatever. They're pretty ruthless in that aspect. So that's what the Wendigo type Bigfoot is. Also, another type, I'm a little hesitant to put this in, but I will include it because people do see them, is the mountain giant. The mountain giant is very rare. You can see on the chart there, mountain giants, when people start talking about, hey, I saw something that wasn't especially wide, it was built more like a human, but it was 17 feet tall, or it was 15 feet tall, or it was 20 feet tall, and sometimes depicted as having some kind of clothing or like loincloths and carrying a club. And when people say that, I'm like, I don't think you encountered a Bigfoot. I know northern Montana has these things, Idaho, the real remote. Yes, there are still a lot of very remote areas in northern, in North America, going up and into Canada and the remote areas. Alaska has a lot of reports of these things. This is where you see the giant overturned trees. And they have fangs that kind of protrude from the bottom. Their lower canines grow into fangs. They're built a lot more like a human. They're built a lot more like a basketball player than a football player, but still very huge, as they're referred to sometimes as the district manager in their area. They kind of keep the other Sasquatches under control. Now, one of the other things you notice is that as we go down this list, we get in a little more rare stuff that people are seeing. Now, down in Florida, a lot of you have heard of the skunk ape. It's kind of a swamp-dwelling, smaller version of a Bigfoot. Now, skunk apes, I also believe that there is a direct variety that tends to look a lot more like a orangutan, like an overgrown, upright human orangutan that lives in Florida. And I think also in Florida, they do have type 2s, your classic wood boogers as well. Like I said, there's a lot of overlap with these species, and people have even seen both types on their property or different types. But I think Florida seems to be home to what you're seeing here is the classic Mayaca skunk ape photos. I did a whole separate video on the skunk ape and breaking down the Mayaca skunk ape videos, because if you look at the proportions and what's going on, it's basically a giant overgrown chimpanzee looking thing, but with a little, orangutan, with a lot longer hair and a lot longer arms and just generally a lot bigger than they get. And people see these things down in Florida, and obviously their name is from their horrible smell. So another type thing that's seen different spots throughout the South, on the East Coast, and going down into the Southwest here and there. These are kind of spotted throughout the United States. I did a whole video on these as well. These are the devil monkeys. These look a lot like an overgrown baboon. There's some reports that they could be like a mandrill or overgrown baboon escaped, but generally the size is a lot bigger than those. And they run in small troops or small packs, and they're generally very aggressive. And people are like, hey, I think I saw something, but it wasn't Bigfoot. It was around on all fours and had, you know, pointy ears and jaws, kind of like a Gugwe, but smaller and on all fours. And, you know, people describe these things as devil monkeys. And if they were feral, if they were feral baboons at some point, or if there's something that have always been here, they're rare, but people do see them. So that's why they're included here on the list. And if they're an offshoot of the other species, I just don't know, but it's something fascinating and people need to know when you're talking about Bigfoot, what a devil monkey is. Now, the Ohio Grassman, the whole video I did talking about the Grassman, they have, it appears to be type 1 and type 2 Bigfoots, because Ohio is a pretty big state and has a pretty varied region of habitat. But they also seem to have something that's not quite like the little 1 and 2 foot tall ones. They seem to have something that's about the size of like almost like a feral human, but covered in hair. So they have type 1s and type 2 Bigfoots in Ohio, so you're Ohio Grassman, and they also have what's reported to be the Dogman creature. Ohio's very busy, but they also have this smaller, almost ape-like, kind of like if you know what the Orang Pendek is, some kind of this small, like, upright wood ape thing that maybe is a smaller offshoot of like a Relic hominid, but there's different videos and different people talking about these things where they've had normal Bigfoot evidence, and then they see these, you know, man-sized, hairy man-ape things in the woods that don't line up necessarily with Sasquatch. So we would call that like a type 9. And they might be closely related to what we call a type 10, or the little people. Now, these are reported all over the United States. They live in a lot of the same areas as the bigger Bigfoots. These are 1 to 3 feet tall, little hairy guys. They look just like a little mini Sasquatch or like a little human, and they're often described as being very aggressive, very mischievous, often like they're protecting something. There's weird stories about orbs and portals and stuff, and these little guys show up. I know even here in Southern California on Otega Highway, there's been stories of these things like running across the road in the middle of the night. Very fascinating. They seem to be, you know, grayed and fully grown at like 1 or 2 feet or 3 feet tall at the most. So like the size of a child, but like covered in hair. So if there's some kind of a dwarf Sasquatch species or something altogether different, or there's some kind of a protector or some kind of a genetic experiment, who knows? Like I said, all these different types are based off of what people have seen and reported, and you can kind of group them into most things people see is going to fit into one of these categories. And that's the 10 basic types. The dishonorable mention, it's not really a type of Bigfoot, is the Dogman. This is, they have like a canine back foot and they stand upright, and there's different varieties of these. These things are ferocious. They're seen all the way up from like Sacramento, all across the Southwest. The border has a lot of activity, going all the way up into the Southeast and all through the, you know, the swamps, the Rougarou, going on all the way up to like the Beast of Bray Road and the middle parts of the United States. These Dogman creatures people see, there's lots of reports of these things. They're very scary. So eventually you look into Bigfoot long enough, or you get into Bigfooting in a lot of areas, and you're gonna encounter or talk about this Dogman type creature. People out there, and they'll hear wood knocks and hoots and hollers from a Bigfoot, and then they find giant tracks, or they hear howls that sound like they're from the largest wolf ever. And a lot of Bigfoot experts and some people say, I don't think that's a Bigfoot, it's something else. As hard as it is to believe, we've done a lot of videos on the Dogman. People are seeing him. So that's why he makes the list as a honorable mention or dishonorable mention, so to speak. So thank you very much. I know we just kind of glazed over him. Like I was saying, we have other videos, the link's in the bottom. But this is just kind of a general starting point. If people need to know, and they're Bigfoot, or they're like, I saw something, but I'm not sure what it was. It had a more human face, or thing looked like an overgrown chimpanzee. You know, that's like a type 2. Or it looked like a giant gorilla. Well, that's like a type 1. Or, yeah, I saw this thing on all fours running around, but it was like some kind of dog monkey thing. It's like, well, I think you saw a devil monkey. And that's basically the point of this guide. Thank you guys very much for watching. A lot of great content coming up. Please hit that like button if you haven't already, and please subscribe. And remember, stay safe in the woods.